Hi, everybody. My name is Jason Ermer, and I am experimenting with this new blog called Collaborative Mathematics. So thanks for checking it out. Since we're brand new, I thought I'd put a little video up here sort of explaining my idea about how this whole thing is going to work. I'm hoping to use video like this as a means of bringing together a community of mathematical problem solvers, like potentially a worldwide community of mathematical problem solvers. I think that'd be pretty cool. Here's the idea. It's got four phases. Phase one, I post a challenge video to YouTube. And in that video, I offer some sort of a mathematical challenge or some sort of a problem to explore, and it'll be posted to our channel on YouTube and linked through the Collaborative Mathematics website. Phase two, you watch the video, and then you explore the mathematical challenge that I present. Ideally, you would do this with some friends. I'm a big believer in collaboration and group work and listening to other people think about a problem, so you could use these challenges as an excuse to get a problem-solving team together and do some interesting mathematics. Then, after you have some ideas about the challenge, maybe you've solved it, maybe you haven't, it's actually okay either way, but once you have some ideas about it, then phase three, you and your problem-solving team make a response video and you post a video response to the challenge video in YouTube. So in your video, you'll explain wherever you are with the problem. Did you solve it? Great! Tell us what you did and how you got there and why your answer is the right answer. Did you get stuck along the way? Also great! We learn a lot from mistakes that we make and places we get hung up, so if you didn't solve the problem, or you're not totally confident about your answer, that's okay. You can tell us where you are. Where did you get stuck? Or how? At what point in the process did you lose your confidence? Anything like that. It's all good, because we can learn from each other no matter what. Because that's what happens in phase four. We have the opportunity to learn from each other, because we can all watch the response videos that other people have submitted and maybe learn something new about the problem. Did everybody solve it the same way? Did somebody solve it in a really creative way that we hadn't thought of? That would be a cool thing to see. Did everybody get the same answer? Does everybody have the same explanation for why that answer is the right answer? Like maybe there's variation in that. Maybe somebody says something in a response video that helps you get unstuck. That would be cool. Maybe something you say helps somebody else get unstuck. You wouldn't maybe know that, but maybe they'll leave you a comment and they'll tell you all about how your video helped them get unstuck. In any case, I think that there's an opportunity for a really interesting conversation that we can all, you know, use to learn about mathematics and about ourselves as problem solvers. I think it's pretty cool. Check out the blog. We're at collaborativemathematics.org. You can find us on Facebook and Google+. Follow us on Twitter. You can subscribe to the YouTube channel. And if you are interested in taking up the challenge, the current video is posted. I'm pointing. Where am I pointing? Oh, it's posted over at collaborativemathematics.org, just over there, or yonder. I don't know what I'm doing. Anyway, go to the website and check it out. And I look forward to seeing what happens next.